Democracy? Democracy. Democracy is not what these people need. Hell, it's not even what they want. America's been trying to install democracies in nations for a century, and it hasn't worked one time.
Warfare has gone to great lengths to reinvigorate Call of Duty. A jump into the future, cybernetic abilities, and the touch of a new lead development team at Sledgehammer Games makes this iteration the biggest and most successful departure since Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare. Advanced Warfare has taken Call of Duty's excellent shooting mechanics and committed completely to the idea that mobility and flexibility are king.
Oh! Oh my god! Did I just hit that?
The topics of Advanced Warfare's bravado-filled story are lent gravity by reflecting real-world news. Weapons of mass destruction.
Oh, and a futuristic version of Seoul, South Korea.
Level upgrade paths. Or is Advanced Warfare New Coke, somewhat like the old, but not exactly the same? Does it alienate gamers with the large jump into the future where the completely new weapon and equipment and the previously mentioned Kevin Spacey Terminator edition cause old and new fans alike to wonder what the fuck everyone was thinking?
Yeah, lucky on your shots, dude, like... No, I accidentally did it again. Okay, I spawned right here. Cool.
Aw, dude.
Right, I got it. In a stealth level, I grappled onto ledges, sneaked through bushes, and found my own paths through dangerous areas. For once, Call of Duty made me feel like a badass without needing to blow anything up. What's truly impressive, though, is how Advanced Warfare occasionally pulls off action worthy of a QuickTime event without any button prompts. I made cool stuff happen on my own terms. And the arsenal is impressive, too, with a variety of mostly typical but great-sounding weapons. Some really stand out, like grenades that highlight enemies or lasers that cut through armor. The most annoying part of the campaign is that we don't have access to the full range of exo movements, like boost jumps and dashes, in every single level. Having that liberating power taken away feels crippling. You do get to use the exosuit all the time in multiplayer, and it's the kind of change I was looking for in Call of Duty. It's intuitive, fun, and it affects everything you do. After just a few matches, I was jumping through windows and onto buildings to get the drop on enemies below. If someone shot me first, I was able to get creative with how I escaped. In modes like Capture the Flag, I felt like I had to be on top of my game, and when I scored a kill, it felt hard-earned and well-deserved.
Come here, buddy. Thank you.